the left-hand side into the Moncton area. Chris O'Neill on the left-hand side with his Chevrolet-powered back motored entry. Papa O'Neill there, just getting them all into the water area so he can get them burned out, right? Okay, they have a little traction compound down for these fellows. Fire in his, but he gets it fired up here. Okay. Okay, Dave Cormier getting set on the right-hand side. Qualifying runs only, folks. This is to determine where they end up on the ladder. Okay. Guys on an 890 index. The name of the game is to get as close to a perfect 890 as you can, and you're qualifying. As you go under that, that moves you way down, okay? You go under when you're racing, of course. 400 flight on the right and 595 on the left. Right side will go 902, 902. Left lane goes an 8928, 8928 on the left-hand side. Right-hand side will get a speed, no speed on him on the right-hand side. Left-hand side will get a speed on him, I would think. And we'll take a look at 142 miles an hour. Next up, little Davey Warman in the left-hand lane. And his Irving Oil backed rear-motored S&W chassis car out of New Brunswick as well. Fredericton car on the right-hand side, the team Sultan entry out of, running out of Marlene's Bridal Salon in Fredericton North, the big block alcohol-burning injected car of Doug Forbes. Injection, fuel injection running out of alcohol, big block Chevy on the right-hand side. Pump gas to left. Bruce, you pick up the two lanes. Traction compound here, they'll be all set. As we continue with action here in the final event in the Moosehead Drag Racing Series for 1987 here at Raceway Park, Prince Edward Island's Motorsports Complex. Fairly fresh motor in Doug Ford's car. It's the first time we've seen him this year. On the right, a 554 light on the left. And the left side goes 874, 8747. And right side goes 8986, 898, if you will, and no speed on the right side. Bruce? Left side goes 874 and 150 miles an hour even. Just do a double check on a photo cell down at the far end there, and we'll carry on everything. Make sure we get our speed situation straightened out on the right side. Cowie, Doaktown, New Brunswick, right side, fine-looking, back-motored, Chevy-powered digger. Chevrolet front-motored car on the left-hand side. Bernie Korsgatten, who lives in Bedford, Nova Scotia, deep in the heart of where all the millionaires live. As very few people realize that actually Bernie always travels around in disguise. He's actually a multi-millionaire, and not a lot of people know that. He has a lot of money and just messes around with his race car for a living. Oh, he goes to work, but that's all a cover, you see. James Cowley, Dope Town, right side. Bernie Korsgatten from Millionaire's Road, Bedford, Nova Scotia, on the left-hand side. Light for Baron on the left, and a 417 light for a very quick James Cowley on the right side. And we'll have a look at the other end and see what's happening down there. Right side goes through with an 886, 886, 888. 139.32, left side goes 8.951. 8.951 for his qualifying time. That'll put him right in there with the men. And we'll have a look at a top speed for Byrne, too, at the other end here. I believe the dragster is off the track down at the far end. We might swing a camera down there if you want guys to have a look at that. Far end of the track, we do have the car off to the left. And I'm not just sure what's going on down there, but we'll take a look and see. We'll send the truck here. They've got their own car going down there to check it out right now. We'll find out what's going on and report back to you. Brenda? Yeah. Alrighty, Dave Garland will be out to qualify in stock eliminator, and Brenda Packham on the right-hand side in the 273 cubic inch, 180 horsepower, two-barrel, small block Mopar wedge out of Carroll Chrysler Plymouth, Windmill Road in Dartmouth, where you get the long deal. Nobody beats a Carroll deal. Drop in and check them out. Rustico Resort here in South Rustico and IGA Food Stores, located conveniently to serve you better and faster throughout the Maritimes. Bracket for bucks, lanes 1, 2, and 3, please. Brackets for dollar, lanes 1, 2, and 3. Dave Garland's 396, originally factory rated at 325 horsepower, coupled to a turbo-hydromatic transmission. Nicely prepared car. Horsepower 273, U-stock automatic on the right side. .396, 325 horsepower car in the left lane. Again, no winner, no loser here. They're qualifying against their NHRA indexes to see where they qualify. On the right side, 661 on the left. Left-hand side of the 1241 elapsed time. And a 1509 on the right-hand side. .106 miles an hour on the left-hand side, right-hand side, and 87.81. Vince Hazel up on the left-hand side, C-front stock automatic. You'll be your number one qualifier unless something goes awry, for sure. Right-hand side, Billy Campbell cuts a 439 light. Well, sir, with the 12:30 elapsed time in the right-hand lane, and left-hand side with a 15:48. Bill on a 12:20 index, 109 miles an hour. Left lane goes 15:48 elapsed time on about a 65 index. He's almost 2/10 under at 85.31 miles an hour. Silver Stock GTI on the left, Sam Harper, Sam's auto repair out of Moncton Chrysler, 340. 255 horse, 350, small block, Silver Stock GTG on the right hand side. And that is Bruce Riley and the Chevy Camaro out of Lake Echo, Nova Scotia, on the right side. One light in the right, a 648 light in the left. Right side goes through with an 11-11 elapsed time. At 121 miles an hour, 11:41, 11:41 on the left-hand side. At 116:28. Stan Speed Shop, Stan Brennan on the left-hand side, Super Stock GT entry as well. Cars 5, 6, 7, and 8, please. 67 Chevy, originally 295 horse, up to 305 horse, 350 in the 80 Oldsmobile Starfire. And the Stan Brennan's car at a Stan Speed Shop in Bridgewater. I believe he makes his home out in New Canada, if my memory serves me correctly. Find another community on the South Shore. Light for Stan on the left-hand side. Both guys are good drivers. Gary Berman been around a long, long time on the left-hand side, well into his 50s. Been racing for many, many years. And on the right-hand side, Bill Shepard, he's been around a long time too, as long as I've been around this area, for sure. One of the original members of the old NSBRA, I believe. Bill and Nancy live in Windsor Junction, Nova Scotia. 340 on the right-hand side. Lots 8-cylinder Chevrolet power stuffed into the Vega in the left lane. On the right-hand side, and Jerry got caught for a bit on the light, 8:75 reaction time in the left lane. Right side will go through with a 12:64 for the win. He'll be back in the next round. 12:64 win for Bill Shepard, 106 miles an hour, 11:25 for Jerry Berman on the left-hand side in the Vega. Gary Bose, Dorchester, New Brunswick, 71 Dodge Charger on the right-hand side. Dorchester, of course, where the penitentiary is, the one place in North America where you don't go to the shower without a soap on a rope. And the left-hand side, dialed at 12:99. Bruce, you want to pick up the two-way there, please? Bruce, pick up the two-way. Gord Wilson, or Phil Green from Riverview, New Brunswick, in a 69 Dodge. 12:10 dial in on the right, 12:99 on the left, 89 100ths of a second head start for the left lane car. He gets to leave first on the Dodge Charger. Mopars by the pair on the line. In the left, 0.91 reaction time on the right. Remember, a perfect reaction time is 500. Right side goes through with a 12.33 on a 12.10. Dial in for the win. Left lane goes 13.21 to scratch. Richard Boyd down to 11.98. He has the by run at this point. Number one qualifier odd car in the class as well, and he gets the by run this trip around for Richard Boyd in the Exterminator entry. He'll be back in the next round. Okay, he goes through the other end. Let's have a look-see here. 12.01 for the win on the by. Rob Fraser, Crossroads, dialed to 12 seconds flat on the left-hand side. Oldsmobile, 455, 68442, 12 to 1290. Dave Atkinson, Calhoun, New Brunswick. On the light, 802 light on the right-hand side, and the 1.106 on the left-hand side. Right side gets there with a 13.15 on a 12.90 for the win. Left lane scratches with an 11.99. Albert Van Wicken dialed a 12.70 in the Super Pro entry, right side. Ronnie Tozer in his new entry, in a 340 Dodge Arrow Super Pro on the left-hand side, Plymouth Arrow rather. Nice looking car. Car is driven on the street as well on the right hand side, and there aren't that many Super Pro cars that can run around and say that these days for sure. That's a brand new entry for Ronnie Tozer on the left side. He's done a nice job putting that together. When he gets some paint on her and stuff, that'll be a real slick looking little unit. .1270 on the right hand side, left lane .1145. Light on the left to 652 on the right. .1279 on the right hand side for the win. Left hand side scratches with .1165. And Moncton, 78 Camaro on the right hand side. Is that 28, 350? Ken Allen, Cove Head, 427, big black Camaro on the left. 1139 dial on him, 1190 on the right hand side. 5100 set start for the left hand side car. That last pair, I think, folks. we'll do a rerun on that last pair there. We got all set with the Camaro here. Doug Constable on the right-hand side. Dial the 1253. On the by run. 563 light. Ed Terrio and the dragster, which is for sale on the left-hand side. That's a 986, Bruce, is that right? Mark Day from Browns Flat, New Brunswick, on the right side. Right, 1242 dial on the right side, left side dial at 986. Two on the right side. Right-hand side, left lane, red lights it by a mile. And the right side was a winner. Left lane's tree didn't even come down. And right side is an automatic win. Left side went through at 11:29 to lose. 12:42 on the right-hand side. Right on his dial-in, the win on the right side. Okay, Super Pro continues here. On the right-hand side, we got Bob Billings running out of All Auto Parts, Bridgewater, and Corky's Auto Body in Blockhouse, dialed at 1197. Left lane dialed at 1268. Super Comp and Super Street right away, please. Jet, Super Comp, Super Street right away. Keith Johnson, Bass River, Nova Scotia, 69 Chevelle, 396, 325 horse. On a Fundy Ready Mix. And R&D Performance and a few other folks. $11.97 on the right-hand side. He'll spot the Chevelle in the left lane, 71 100s. Or 7/10, if you will, of the second head start for the left-hand side. $6.13 light on the left, a 590, slightly better light for Bob Billings on the right-hand side in the All Auto Parts entry. Left side goes through with a 1261 under by 7/100s. Right-hand side goes 1193 under by 4/100s. Right side is the winner. For sure, Medard LeBlanc, Boudreaux, Service Center, Memram, Cook, New Brunswick, Spot Block, Ford, powered Ford, Pinto, dialed at 1120 on the right-hand side, left lane dialed at 1261. That is Erwin Mossman from Grand Tragedy on the left-hand side. Currently sitting in fourth spot in points. Medard is in third spot in points right now, 5 points ahead of him in the points race. 487 here in the Moosehead Series. LeBlanc red-lighted it away. I don't remember the last time he red-lighted. A 494 red light for Medard LeBlanc on the right side. Left lane goes through with a 1273 for the win. Right side scratches. Ronnie Tozer's car, I'm not sure who's driving it today. Maybe him, but I don't think. He's trying to drive too, if he is. Dial the 1220, car for sale. Roy and York out of Upham's Auto Body and R&D Performance Center Truro area in the York and York Duster. This car here on the left-hand side is another one of Vince Hazel's old cars, who you'll see in stock Eliminator a little bit later on this afternoon with a little Pontiac Phoenix. Roy having a little trouble getting that line lock to hold there. Vince campaigned that as a stock Eliminator automatic transmission car a number of years ago. In fact, I think he still had that car when I started in Penfield announcing up there, what, 8 years ago now? Gosh, I think so. Nice looking car, good bracket performer. Wright has done a lot of winning with this car. 1239, and he's out of Nova Scotia, of course, with the car. 1220 dialing on Ronnie Tozer's New Brunswick-based entry on the right side, 19/100ths of a second, or almost 2/10ths. Head start for the left side. The base light on the right hand side for Ronnie Tozer's car. $12.65 on the left hand side, $12.65 for the wind. Right side scratches with a $12.31. 100 miles an hour in the left lane. Dorian Capillet, 440, 375 horse Duster. Dorian on the right side. $5.55 light on the right side at 12.32 on a 30 dial, so he's obviously on the mark with his dial in at 12.30. And he'll be back the next round. Lives on Madison Avenue, one of those Madison Avenue guys in Fredericton. They're all wealthy, we all know that. He's also a heck of a painter. He did Cowie's car and several others. I believe he had a hand in Doug Forbes' paint job as well. If you want to see an artist with a paint gun, go have a look at this guy. He does nice work. 831 light on the left-hand side, and 1.157 light on the right side for Bruce Bell. So Robin may be in good shape here. We'll see what happens at the other end. He goes through first with an 11.24 on a 10.90 dial, of course, to win. And 97 miles an hour, heads up running here, 1090 index is what we're doing, 1120 at 121 miles an hour to scratch on the right side for Bruce Bell. Running out of Marco Polo Land, the obsession car, McLean Racing, Paul McLean, Hunter River on the left-hand side, Super Street action continuing. Steve Lewis on the right-hand side on a mountain with a small block flip-top former funny car Chevy Camaro in the right lane. On the left and 962 on the right. Heads up racing, 1090 index, can't run quicker than 1090. Left side goes through with a 1083, under by 7/100ths. Right side will win it with a 1094. Left side broke out on the run. He went a 1083. That means that Glenn McLean, if he can get through the next round or the round after that, is going to beat Paul out for points for the year. But there he is on the right hand side. Derby EPI Dr. Brothers Lewis Smith Racing, John Hambley out of Eastern Fiberglass Maritime Engine Specialty, Silicon Sons of B&N Construction on the left-hand side, 1090 cars, heads up, and here they go on the way to the other one. The brakes, left side goes a 1076, right side goes under as well, but he goes 1080, and he will be back in the next round. The left lane went under by 14/100ths of a second, right side went under by a tenth. Right side is the winner. He'll be back in the next round. John Hambley breaks out by more. Mike McDonald out of Moncton area with the 426 Stage 3 Maxi Wedge. Ram inducted, originally rated at 425 horsepower, 426 Wedge. On the left side, car for sale, and it's a runner, Raymond Ingram from Heritage Cedar Home. Ray runs out of Lower Sackville, Nova Scotia, and he's one of the finer Finnish carpenters that you will run into during the week. A carpenter by trade and a drag racer by choice. On the left side with a big block Chevrolet, cars for sale, turnkey, price is right, check it out. You want to go super street racing, boy, this is the plan. I'm here to tell you, that's a fine, well-constructed car, and it is available right now. The one in the car of my dreams on the right-hand side, always like these old Max Wedges, I'll tell you. Mike McDonald takes out to the 535 light to Ray Ingram, 611 light. You don't see that too often. Ray's one of the sharp start line guys in this game, no question about it. Left side goes through with a 10905 on a 10900 dial for the win. 1108, a little off the place of pace for Mike McDonald on the right-hand side. Left side, 108 miles an hour. We'll get a mile an hour at 1108 on the right-hand side for Mike McDonald and the Maxi Wedge. That must have been tight at the other end at 121 miles an hour. Number one qualifier in Super Street on the left-hand side, a car that normally runs Super Gas. He slowed it down from an 890 car to from a 990 car to a 1090 car for today. Jim Morrison out of Performance Auto World in Dartmouth, Nova Scotia, deep in the heart of Burnside on the left-hand side. Left-hand side of 1023 on the bye, 1023 on the bye for Jim. He'll be back the next round. Mile an hour wise, well, let's have a peek just for fun here. Because it's all the same price. Doug Forbes on the left-hand side, the Doug and Marlene Forbes entry, back motored, fake block Chevrolet on injection with alcohol going through them. On the right-hand side, back motored small block Chevrolet on pump gas with carburetors. The Team Irving entry of little Davey Warburton. Dave Mormon, slick, pumped up, and really cranked today after receiving his new teddy bear. On the start line, just before the start of today's show, it has left him at a loss for words and has really pumped him up. He's going to be a dangerous man out here in Super Cup Eliminator, no question about it. Getting heated up on the tire department here on the left-hand side as well as the right. First run in the first round of Super Cup Eliminator in the final event of the Moosehead Export Drag Racing Series here for 1987 at Raceway Park. These guys really crank about folks. Keep an eye on them. They run on an 890 index, 8.90 seconds. That's what they got to run. They race heads up. Obviously no handicap because they all got the same index and they cannot run quicker than 890. They got to get those weenies good and sticky on the rear in order for them to hook all those gobs of horsepower on the ground, because obviously when the tires go up the spoke of this, they don't go see it all. And that's why they fuss around with all that traction compound and stuff and get them hot and sticky. .566 reaction time on the left side for Doug Forbes, right side Dave Warman, red lights it away. Red lights it away. What a sin. He goes through the other end with a 925, 914 for the win for Doug Forbes. It's a tough way to lose a race. Dougie's in there. He'll be back in the next round. Haven't seen him for a while. Good to see him doing well. 128-21 as he takes her easy down the other end. Coming up next, Team Irving. Joe Roy's entry, Dave Cormier, the wheel. Moncton, New Brunswick, right-hand side. The Ultramar Eldon Sign Shop Special of Chris and Neil O'Neill on the left side. Chris behind the wheel, 17 years old. He has won the Super Comp points here for the season this year, first year at it. He's doing well. Gets a sharp little shoe. Reads the tree real well. And his dad has been helping him, of course, obviously, with the car a lot. His dad works in the CN maintenance end of things down in Halifax at the moment. On the right-hand side, the Irving team entry marked the first entry, to my knowledge anyway, in the recent years of Irving into motorsport sponsorship. Good place for him to be. More and more large companies every day are realizing that motor racing is a great place to advertise your products and services. Due to the incredible increase in crowds and, of course, press coverage and all the rest of it that's gone along with the growth of our sport, due to the help of large companies like Moosehead and Shell and people like that that have helped us out over the years, as I see more companies than ever getting involved in it. Ultramar car on the left, Irving car on the right, the battle of the all companies on the line. 510 light on the right, a 555 light on the left, the best light that Dave Cormier's ever cut with the car, to the best of my knowledge. Left side goes through with an 889. 8898, 2/1000ths of a second under. 8898, 133 miles an hour, 906 on the right-hand side, a 9066, 147.55. That is a heart, 2.35 miles an hour, 12.23, 3/100ths off the index for Bill Campbell, a scratch on the right-hand side. Of course, he's running for the Bookmark people, by the way, with 15 stores to serve you all over New Brunswick. And a racer's needs serviced especially at Bookmark locations, 15 stores throughout the province of New Brunswick. Right-hand side, Super Stock Eliminator. This is also a 5 on the cameras there, guys. A Super Stock Eliminator. As we get going here with Bruce Riley on the right-hand side in just a couple of moments. .255 horse, .350 small block on the right-hand side. 69 vintage motor in a much later car, of course. That's what makes it a Super Stock GT. This one a GTG on an 1110 index this trip. 1144, I believe, on the left-hand side. For Sam Harper in the Sam's Auto Repair entry, also running out of Moncton Chrysler Dodge, 340, 275 horsepower. A-engine wedge in a later model Chrysler Cordoba Superstock GTI. He gets a slight head start. Okay, just getting everything cleared away at the far end of the track. All set. Super Stock Eliminator, first run in the first round. Bruce Riley, Lake Echo, Nova Scotia, small block Chevy powered, Chevy Camaro, right hand side with the power glide, left hand lane, A engine 340 wedge, Mopar in the Chrysler Cordoba, Salisbury, New Brunswick, Sam, Upper Sam's Auto Repair, APM Limited, and Moncton Chrysler. .692 light on the left, .696 light on the right-hand side, almost equal on the start line. Right side goes through, 11-10 on an 11-10, folks. 11-10 and 11-10 for the win at 117 miles an hour, 11-44 on a 41 index on the left-hand side for Sam Harper at 111 miles an hour. Number one qualifier, Stan Brennan, with his Superstock GT entry out of Stan's Speed Shop, Bridgewater. 305 horse, 350, originally rated at 295 horsepower back at 67 in the Camaro SS package. The motor was since up horsepower by NHRA. They factored it to 305 horse. That's what's in a 67 Camaro type engine and an Oldsmobile Starfire. They're allowed to do that. Corporate switching is what they call it. Superstock GTC. Last call, bracket for bucks, guys. Last call, bracket for bucks, okay? Last call on the 50-50 drive. 027-885. Check your tickets, folks. The red ticket, 027-885. Claim them right away or we draw another number. Light for Stan Brennan on the left-hand side and the Olds of Starfire. Left-hand side goes 10-53, 10-53 at 127 miles an hour. Light on the time pass for Bill Campbell on the right-hand side. And a 12:42 at the other end. For Bucks and Super Street, please. Gary Bowes, Dorchester, New Brunswick, who is currently holds down the honors of having the quickest reaction time of the day so far. And if he manages to hold on to it, he'll get $100 from Brackley Jeep Eagle. Your new Jeep is in stock right now with a full line of Jeep and Medallion at Brackley Jeep Eagle, Brackley Point Road, 1 mile north of the world-famous Charlottetown Airport. Albert Van Wicken up next to him, dialed at 1270, right side dialed at 1210. With a 359 red light in the right lane, left lane will be the winner on this one. Right side goes through with a 1221, 1221 at 112 miles an hour, left lane of the 1327. Constable, 396 Camaro on the left-hand side from the island here. Dial to 1253, right side dial to 1201. Exterminator with a 444 reaction time. 590 light for Doug Constable as he takes home the bacon in this round. There you can see it on the screen. Well, at least I can anyway. Right side goes through the scratch in a 12 flat, 113 winner, 1244 in the left lane, 97 miles an hour. Royden York and the York and York R&D Performance Centers Rick Upham Auto Body entry. Right side, Mark Day. With a 65 Chevy 400 small block, formerly out of the McLean Racing family of fine cars. $766 light on the left of 5:27 reaction time on the right-hand side. He trimmed him on the start line. Roy New York will have his work cut out for him here unless he can hopefully shove the right-hand side guy under. The right side goes through with a 12:61 for the win. 102 miles an hour, 12:39 for Royden on the left-hand side. A darn good attempt at it, but got caught a bit on the tree at 109 miles an hour. Last call bracket for Bucks. Let's get him in the lanes right away as we continue down into the nitty-gritty, or the money runs, if you will, in this final event in the Moosehead Export Drag Racing season for 1987 here at Raceway Park. Toys Exhibition Drive Charlottetown on the right hand side. Bike is for sale, and he's down to 969 left hand side. This time around is Jerry Phillips, Clifton Royal. That bike's for sale as well. He's down at 11.05 seconds handicap time on him, and a 969 on the right hand side. 1.36, roughly. The time head start for the left-hand lane. And the right side will go through for the win. The right side goes through with a 9:63 elapsed time. 134.13 miles per hour. Bruce, number off the left side. Never mind. Don Westaway from Harrington on the left-hand side. And on the right side, Dave Ferguson from Cape Breton. I'll be back in just 1 second here as we continue on with Bike Eliminator here at Raceway Park.
.647 reaction time left hand side, 6:46 and right, 13:09 left hand side, 10:83 on the left right hand side. 13:09 is under. Left side breaks out. Right side will come back. He runs a 10:83 on a 10:72 dial in. Bruce, the number on the left. Thank you.
King, I think, ready on the right-hand side. And the McLean Sports OMAC to New Brunswick base entry, and he is dialed at 972. The left-hand side may have broken. Yes, he did. Right side puts it through the other end with a 1077, taking her easy on the pass. 124.31. That obviously wasn't Boo King, that trip around. That was Murt McDonald, I believe, from Sydney. Gord Ferguson, excuse me, from Cape Breton on the right. Now Boo King will be ready to go. I think we've got it all sorted out now. He's dialed at 972. 12 seconds flat on the left-hand side. Sheldon Douglas, Dartmouth, in the right, left lane. Running out of McLean Sports in Oromocto on the right-hand side is Boo King. At 980, 134 miles an hour. Bruce Riley, Lake Echo, Nova Scotia. 350, 255 horsepower, spa block on the right-hand side. 1105 dial under. Stan Brennan, 1054 dial under. Superstock GTC, 305 horse, 350, spa block, 67 motor. And the Stan Speed Shop Oldsmobile Starfire. It's a 5-2, fellas. I'm sure you're rolling it, but in case you aren't, it's a 5. These guys can both chop down the tree like a pair of woodsmen. This one will more than likely be won on the start line. This is your basic driver's race right here. To the left at a 558 on the right-hand side. And that one's going to go to Bruce Riley this trip around. Left lane goes through with a 1047, right side 1102. 1102 elapsed time on the right-hand side. Trophy cars, get them up there, guys. Let's go. Trophy cars, bring them up. In bracket for Bucks on the line here with Randall Clough in the Oldsmobile, Al McLeod in the Brackley Beach-based Mustang. .809 light on the left-hand side. And a 5-11 on the right-hand side for Randall Clough. On the brakes on the right side, a 1386 for the win. First and second in bracket for Bucks, Randall Clough, Pleasant Grove, 1380 dial-in, Arnold Trainer, Charlottetown, in the Mighty Mopar, dollar 1450, as they heat them up properly and get ready for the final. Super Pro, can we have you to the lanes right away, please? Car 236 Super Pro to the lanes right away, please. Right side of the 1379. Reaction time on the right is 603 on the left-hand side. Right-hand side goes through with a 970. Right side the winner with a 970 at 120 miles an hour. Left side scratches with a 1081 and a 1080. Got caught a little on the line, and that's where the story was told. Brenda Packham and Vince Hazel, as soon as you're ready, bring them up to the lanes. Final and trophy, Richard Legere on the right-hand side, and that should give Richard Legere the points for the year. It will, and bracket for trophy. Mopar dollar 1450 as they heat them up properly and get ready for the final. 236 Super Pro, can we have you to the lanes right away, please? Car 236 Super Pro to the lanes right away, please. Right side of the 1379. Okay, right-hand side. Broke out by 01 on the last one. Left side by 2100s. Right-hand side, the winner, Randall Clow, Pleasant Grove, picking up the bucks. In bracket for Dollars Arnold Trainer, Charlottetown, finishing up in second spot on the last pass. So there will be a runoff between Brenda Packham and the wagon. And Vince Hazel to see who wins the points in Stock Eliminator for 1987, as they have finished up in a tie situation for the season here. So that'll be coming up in a short while. Stand by. Loser gets third here, I do believe. King, McLean Sports, Oramato, your 1987 points champ and bike eliminator. Gord Ferguson, Cape Breton. Out of Ramsey's Honda on the left-hand side. Reaction time on the right is 6:03 on the left-hand side. Right-hand side goes through with a 9:70. Right side the winner with a 9:70 at 120 miles an hour. Left side scratches with a 10:81 and a 10:80. Got caught a little on the line, and that's where the story was told. Brenda Packham and Vince Hazel, as soon as you're ready, bring them up to the lanes. Final and trophy, Richard Legere on the right-hand side, and that should give Richard Legere the points for the year. It will, and bracket for trophy. Okay, on the right-hand side, Richard Legere gets to the other end first with a 13-16 for the win at 87 miles an hour. On the left-hand side, a 13-32 and a 13-05 dial-in for runner-up position for the day. That gives Richard Legere the points. Robert Fleming Shediac finished up second place on a daily basis in the weight-serving Mopar. Fourth place in Super Pro goes to the winner here. Okay, Richard Boyd on the right hand side, dialed at 11:95. And on the left hand side, in the 71 Dodge Charger moving up against Richard Boyd and the Exterminator. 12:15 on the left and 11:95 on the right. There's going to be 2/10 of a second head start for the left lane car. Gary Bowes also has the $100 so far for the best reaction time in the Eliminator today, courtesy of the folks at Brackley Jeep Eagle. Gary Bowes picks it up. You can see it on your screen there. For those of you watching at home, we will be later on. The big red light on the right side, the left lane, that picks it up, takes it back to Dorchester. Right side goes through with an 11:96, 1/100th off his dial, too bad. 12:16 on the left side, 1/100th over his dial as well for the win. This is it. This is for all the bacon here. And Super Pro, Constable, on Island Air Plus on the left-hand side, dial at 12:50, right side dial at 12:42. Mark Day, Browns Flats, New Brunswick on the right-hand side. Let's see what goes on at the other end. Left lane to 6:29, a 5:49 light on the right-hand side. Left lane goes through at 12:60. For the win, he didn't get as good a light, but by gosh, he got there first and over his dial, 96 miles an hour. Right side went off his pace with a 12:75 and scratches and gets up second place, so that's still not bad. They'll be dancing in the streets in Browns Flat, New Brunswick later on tonight anyway. Hang the expense. Chevy Coupe buying the street rod for sure on his way down to the left side. Thank you to Michael Scully and Alan Vincent for your help today and anybody else that was involved with the Princess. I appreciate it, gentlemen. Left lane goes through 1365, 97 miles an hour. Okay, coming up for the final. This will be the final run of the season for the final run of the 1987 season in the Moosehead Export Drag Racing Series, which has been another ripping success here at Raceway Park, Prince Edward Island's Motorsports Complex. That little gal is also my wife, driving that wagon over there, and she wants this one bad, I'll tell you. She wanted it bad going in, was talking about it all week. She's ready. U-Stock Automatic, the only gal ever to win a season's championship in any drag racing division in the eastern half of Canada. She won it last year. And this is for all the bacon for the whole season coming up here on the line right now. 270, 380 horsepower. on the right side at a Carroll Chrysler. Nobody beats a Carroll deal on Windmill Road, Dartmouth. Rustico Resort, IGA Food Stores, and Provincial Sanitary Products in Halifax as she heats up the weenies and gets it all ready to make it happen. Vince Hazel, the racing grandfather, multi-time national record holder and super winner from Falmouth, Nova Scotia. Maritime Forestry Products, Heritage Cedar Homes. What a way to wrap up the season. You gotta realize what an emotional roller coaster this is for me, for sure. $14.99 dial-in on the right-hand side. That's a $14.99 dial on the right there, Bruce. I guess you probably see that okay. And on the left-hand side, dial at $15.43. The front stock automatic on the left-hand side. Side. If she doesn't break out, she might be in good shape when she gets to the other end. This is going to be close. This is for all the wieners right here. At the other end of the track, right side goes a 14.89. She broke out left lane with a 15.45 for the win. Right side went too damn fast. What a heartbreaker. Well, it was close, folks. I can tell you that. Left lane will win it for the season. Right-hand side and runner-up spot for the year for points. She cut a super light, a 5.05 on the line, but just went too bloody fast to the other end and broke out. Little message for Fat John there. I guess Doug isn't all washed up either. Anyway, folks, hope you had a good time here. We did too. We'll join you tomorrow afternoon at 2 o'clock here at Raceway Park, Prince Edward Island's Motorsports Complex. Hello, series. On behalf of the management here at Raceway Park, thank you for coming out today and supporting us all season long. And on behalf of the folks at Moosehead Breweries, our major sponsors here, who've done such a lot to promote our sport, we look forward to seeing you back here on the long weekend in May next year for the first event of the 1988 Moosehead Export Drag Racing Series here at Raceway Park.
George Boyle in the 42. 74 is Bud Sutherland. The 6 is Kevin McKay. David Reeves in the 55. Elmer Cameron in 34. Kenny Goody in the 93. Mike Hicken in the 9. Wayne Phillips in the 82. Fred Van Dunkirken in the 2. Shane Kerman in the 88. And we're all set to get it underway here on a Labor Day in a race. Way Park, one more lap. Make sure they stay in order, because as you can easily see, a couple of them tried to jump the gun. Mike McCarville again in the 10. Mike Lamb in 44. Bob McKenzie in the 4. Bob Ford, 71. George Boyle in 42. As we get everybody all lined up, make sure that they're in their proper sequence. Lots of interesting giveaways and neat stuff to pass along to you today, so make sure you don't get too far away from your lucky number programs. 50-50 draw tickets are available right through the crowd. We'll be giving some goodies away there as well throughout the race day here at Raceway Park. All set with the first heat for the mini stock division. There goes the green flag. We're underway. Mike Gallant at the wheel of the 44. Mike McCarville starting to move up in the 10 in the Taylor's garage entry as he makes his move in the low groove and starts going for the front. Dave Reeves makes a move on the inside outside in the 55. There he goes, and then roars right to the front. Kenny Goody in the ADL Dairy Products, number 93, hops into second spot with a deft maneuver going into turn number 3 and coming out of 4, and he looks good. Out goes the yellow. And we have developed some kind of a problem here someplace. They display the yellow flag. We got a bumper on the track is what's going on here. And they'll go out and hop out there and pick that up in just a second. And the there's the hop to it and get it done in a hurry cleanup crew. And they're frankly G. Meagle Hayden. And they'll get that out of the road and back in short order again. Next time you're out shopping for a pickup, you might just take one of those for a drive. So, two or three laps into it anyway, it certainly isn't going to be any shortage of action here this afternoon. We got a ton of Duke's cars. We got some Duke's guys visiting us. We're over Nova Scotia that normally run over at Riverside Speedway, and Andy Ganish, they're here today as well. We'll have some info on those guys as we get a little bit closer to what's happening here this afternoon. All the action you can handle, and then some in spades as we get into the final points race in the Shell TLO Series for 1987 here at Raceway Park, Prince Edward Island's Motorsports Complex. Coming out of the turn, and we're ready to nail her. Here they come, down for the green flag. Dave Reeves up front, followed by Kenny Goody in the 93. Mike McCarville in the 10. Fred Van Dunkirken making a move on him in the number 2. And 6 comes Kevin McKay in the Car Life Museum Team Toyota entry. Mike Hicken in the number 9. Running out of East End Tire. Followed by the hard charging 71 of Bob Ford. We got a real mittful of minis out here today. These guys are really going to put on a show in their own way, that's for sure. Dave Reeves still holding down the lead, coming out of the turn and whistling down the front stretch in the 55. Kenny Goody in the 93. Fred Van Dunkirken trying for that second spot in the number 2. As he makes a bold move on the inside and tries to get Kenny Goody, but he hauls him on the top end, and they go neck and neck into 3 and 4. Mike Hicken on the other side of Mike McCarville in the Taylor's Garage, number 10. Mike Hicken moving up in the 9 as he makes a bid for it on the straight stretch. Kevin McKay in the Car Life Museum entry moving up as well. These guys are really sailing, folks. Kirkin now moves up into second spot, down the backstretch, behind the 55. And here comes your leader down the front, into the chute, followed by Fred Van Dunkirken, Kenny Goody, Mike Hicken, Mike McCarville, and Kevin McKay. Kevin McKay tries to get underneath Mike McCarville. Has he got enough suds to do it? No, sir. He had a half a fender on him. He'll try now in the low groove. Here he goes again. Tries to get underneath Mike McCarville. He'll go high this time. Didn't quite make it. He'll slow down and try to do it over and shoot Payam in a slingshot move. But Mike McCarville gets up high and shuts the door off. Here comes Kevin now on the other side. He'll try him on the high road. Mike Hicken moving up again in the number 9 on Kenny Goody. Look at this, neck and neck down the backstretch. Mike McCarvo holds him off, and here comes Kevin McKay down the front stretch. He's by him. Still up front with Brett Van Dunkirken in second spot, and the third place battle with Mike Hicken and Kenny Goody. As Mike Hicken moves by Kenny Goody on the inside in the number 9 up into third spot. But can he hang on? That's the question. Dave Reeves in the 55, your leader. You can just take a quick look right behind him and you'll see the number 2 and Fred Van Dunkirken coming right into the screen. There he goes. And down a front stretch. There's your winner, Dave Reeves in the 55. Fred Van Dunkirken in second spot in the number 2. And Mike Hicken, I believe, finishing third of the 9, followed by Kenny Goody and Kevin McKay. Let's have a nice hand for our folks when he gets up here for the checkered flag. His first win of the season after a tough, tough year. Dave Reeves in the 55. Nice run for him. He's been waiting for that one for a while, I'll tell you.
That's your next show, dog. Yeah. Take a number.
Okay, nice hand for him, Dave Reeves, as he hands back the checkers. Alrighty, first race in the first division of Dukes of Hazzard Division here today at Raceway Park. Sterling Rattray in the 31, Daryl Matheson in the number 92, Sandy McKay in the 43, Gerald McCory in the 50, Fred Barrett in the 74, Greg McKenna in the 7, Walt McCory in the 60, Daryl Ford in the 35, Joey McDonald in the 83, Dave Tierney in the 49, Henry Lenzel in the 57, Dave Clements in the 78, Scott Livingston 24, Rod O'Connor in the 63, Kevin Shaw in the 79, Marv Dyer in the 17, Wade McKinnon in the 81. There you have them all out there in front of you. Formed up and ready to go.
Yes.
Raven Birthplace.
Oh, yeah, one that had no backing in that.
What's her name? Gina?
Cena.
Cena.
Yeah,
okay. Fournier. Cena Fournier, you won our first tote bag. Congratulations there, Cena. Well, there you have Sterling Rattray, led putting it into an early lead in the 31. Oh, the 50 hops into the boonies. Gerald McQuarrie at the wheel there as he stuffs her into the weeds coming out of 1 and 2. And gets her all sorted out and hits for the track once again. There's your leader early, Sterling Rattray, blowing a bit of oil, but hanging right in there. Daryl Matheson up next in the 92, followed by, whoa, Sandy McKay. We got a real mix-up over there between 1 and 2. Three of them into it. Walt McQuarrie comes back out of the weeds. And Kevin Shaw in the 79 gets spun around there. Henry Lenzel as well over in the right-hand side. Coming out, and it looks like Henry may be immobilized from over there. So one lap into it. The action starts here at Raceway Park. Action is probably will not stop for a good long time. Looks like Henry Lenzel may have chucked a wheel or collapsed a ball joint or something over there. Looks like the car is kneeling down and begging for mercy at the moment. You can't hardly blame it, really. They'll get hooked onto him in a minute. Folks at Shaw's Towing did their usual credible job here of making sure that the track is kept clear of non-functioning automotive equipment, and they'll get it out of there in just a sec.
Number
Action here. We got the green flag underway. Here we go. Once again, as Raceway Park continues on a triple header, Labor Day blast here at Prince Edward Island's Motor Sports Complex. Sterling Rattray up front. Darrell Matheson in second spot. The 43 of Sandy McKay in third. Greg McKenna fourth. Joey McDonald fifth right now. Dave Tierney is still driving in fear that his mother-in-law may come back to watch him in sixth. Here comes Wade McKinnon coming on strong in the Apple Auto Glass Chandler Brothers Welding. McKinnon Brothers number 81 Chevrolet going high. He takes the high road in the big 81 and he is flying. He is your points leader in the Shell TLO point series for 1987 so far here at the park. Look at him come on. He got around the mess there for sure. Others were not so lucky. Scott Livingston among them. Kevin Shaw hits right straight for the bull rushes to try and stay out of the way. And they kept it moving. No yellow flag, so we're all right. Sterling Rattray still way out in front, and the black flag comes out for Joey McDonald, I think. And I'll check on that and find out. He'll get it again for sure if it's not if it is for him. There goes Sterling in the lead, followed by Darrell Matheson, Sandy McKay. Wade McKinnon now up in fourth spot. Okay, Joey McDonald with the black flag takes off pit side in the 83. There's your leader right now, the 31. McKinnon gets a chance to make his move in the 81 as he goes underneath Darrell Matheson down the backstretch, heading into turn number 3 and 4. He's up in second spot almost. Darrell Matheson hanging on like grim death. Wade McKinnon going to drive away from him right here. Here he comes down the front stretch. He's motoring. He's now up in second spot, and he's got Sterling Rattray in his gun sight. Watch him go down the backstretch as he tries to make up some ground and go for it. Still out in front, 31, Sterling Rattray. We'll whip a camera on that 81 going down the backstretch right now. Take a look at him because he is really starting to move up on him. 81 up in second spot now. He'll be coming into the turn. There he comes. Can he do it? Look at old Marv McLean, Marv Dyer in the 17. And the FR McLean Dodge, he's starting to make up some ground as well. He's up in third spot already and moving. He's in second spot in points for the year, right behind this guy you're looking at right now, Wade McKinnon. Wade McKinnon's not only got to catch Sterling Rattray, but he's got to hold off that 17 of Marv Dyer, and that is not easy to do, so he's right in the middle at the moment. Here's your leader, Sterling Rattray, in the Island Fertilizers Lounsbury equipment entry. Will you look at old Marv Dyer? Marvin Dyer is just flying in that Mopar as he catches right up to the 81 here, and he'll make it interesting for him and Rattray before they're done. Woo, look at him go. Okay, now the game of catch-up is almost complete. They got one lap left to go. Can Wade McKinnon get by him in one lap? This ought to be interesting, and here comes Marv Dyer right on his tail. Here's where judgment comes in. Can Sterling Rattray hold him off in the traffic? Here goes Wade McKinnon on the outside, and here comes Marv Dyer on the other side. Oh, look at this. Oh, look at this. This is incredible. Unreal. Oh, look at him. What a finish. First, second, and third right across the line. Sterling managed to hold him off, and Wade McKinnon tried his darndest to get by, and Marv making sure that he was right in there. You don't find a finish any closer than that. I don't care where you go racing. That's probably some of the best you'll ever see. We'll give him a nice hand, folks, as he comes around to pick it up at the Island Fertilizers, Lounsbury Industrials, Monte Carlo, Sterling Rattray, the old rat himself. Give him a big hand there, folks.
Shell 9 8 4 3 2 1. Check your hands up there, folks. 9 8 4 3 2 1.
Nice hand for him, Sterling Rattray. We'll give you the official finish of the whole race here in just a second. Let's hear it for the 31. Good job as he hands in the flag. Second division of Dukes of Hazzard here, and this is the first heat for them. Train Rushton in the 27, and let's see, Carol Jollymore in the 9, but I'm not sure whether Carol's driving it today or not. Glenn Singleton in the 6, John McPhee in the 11, Dean Dollar in the 97, Mike Wilson in the 45, Paul McLean in the 82, Alan Sudsbury in the 55, Glenn Tuplin in the 70, Kevin Curtis in 29, Jackie Bernard in the 94, John McLeod 22, Wayne Warren in the 3, Orion Smith in the 67, Lauren Bingley in the 5, Jerry McKinnon in the 91, Barry Flip McLeod in the 34, and Regis Coffin in the 53. 86, Fred Duffy out there as well in the Pontiac. We should get a green flag very shortly here to get him started. Here we go. All righty, underway. Train Rushton up front. Next to Glenn Singleton. And I think that's Cal Jollymore driving Carroll's number 9 today, probably. And here comes Train in the lead in the Chevy Nova, that was a drag car many years ago, as a matter of fact, out on the drag strip here. And the 6 car, Glenn Singleton, gets a little out of shape there as John McPhee takes a look at his spot and figures that's where he ought to be. But look out, because the 22 is on his way in there as well. John McLeod moving up in the Sea Treat restaurant entry. Lauren Bingley in the Peter Pan drive-in. Bingley's auto body number 5 gets hit. Oh, gets hit again, but he's still going. And, of course, that cost John McPhee a little bit in there between 1 and 2. He's going to get out of there in a hurry. Train Rushton in the lead. Look at the action here. Jackie Bernard on the move in the 94. He was the hot dog out here Saturday night. He was really sailing, and he's looking for a spot to park that big Pontiac right now. Out comes the yellow. We still got the 11 down there between 1. Whoa! Flip McLeod and Glenn Tuplin, and I'm not sure who else got into it there. They're okay, though. No victims at this point. They all managed to get out of it and get back on track. Barry McLeod's brother, the Brackley Beach Bomber from yesterday, had quite an interesting experience here on the drag strip as well, as Al McLeod did some rather neat and heretofore unknown maneuvers at the far end of the quarter mile when he hammered the brakes. No dull folks in the McLeod household, I tell you. Okay, we'll get hooked on to the 11. We'll get him out of there in just a second. We'll be back as the action continues here at Raceway Park, Prince Edward Island's Motorsports Complex, in the final day of the Shell TLO Series for 1987 on the Moosehead Oval. And here comes the 22. Keep an eye on John McLeod. He's having a hot day here. Look at him go. 55 moving up nicely as well. Cal Jollymore's old car. Alan Sudsbury at the wheel. And Lauren Bingley in the Peter Pan driving. Bingley out of body Monte Carlo in third spot. Making up some ground here as he backs off and picks his corner. '91 having a little fun there, Jerry McKinnon. Jerry McKinnon and Kevin Curtis got their own race going there. Lauren Bingley makes a bid for second spot and almost had it tied up there for a second. John McLeod holds him off. Lauren Bingley makes a move again. Still sitting in third. He'll take the low road, he said, thank you.
and see if he can get him on the chute coming down. Your leader, Train Rushton, way out in front in the 27. 22 gets a bit high this time around, but it still worked for him as he holds off Lauren Bingley. Now Lauren Bingley makes his move in the number 5. Is it going to be enough? No, sir. He gets held off again. And here comes Al Sudbury in the 55. Trying to take advantage of the situation. Still sitting in fourth. But he may be looking at third here in just a second. Whoa! Lauren Bingley and Al Sudbury get hooked up, but they get straightened out all right. Lauren Bingley gets underneath them, but not enough. Car is not handling well. Monte Carlo is plowing badly in the corners. He's turning the wheels, but it's going straight ahead. And I believe in third spot, unofficially, Al Sudbury in the 55.
Check that thing out once again, folks, for the last draw. 988763, okay? 988763. Bring up 5 minutes, or we'll give you back to somebody else. As your coat.
Nice hand from John McLeod. Good job. Running out of the House of Excellence and the Sea Treat Restaurant in his Chevrolet. First checkered flag ever for him, by the way. We'll give him a real good shot when he gets back here. There's ballots in the programs today, folks. You should pick up a program over at the information booth. If you haven't got one yet, pick up a program right away. There are ballots. You can vote for your favorite driver and all the rest of it. And also, if any of you folks have presentations to make, it'll be 2 weeks from today, okay? Robbins in the 12 had a flag here the other night, looking real good. Carl Livingston out of Ben Livingston and Sons in the number 16. Roddy McDonald out of Cecil Poly Construction in car number 44. Al McPhail in the McPhail and Peters Island Bandag Tire Retreaders Chevrolet Camaro. Al Beaton in the Beaton Farms number 27. Eddie McLaren in the Eastern Fiberglass. And custom paint number 11 Mustang, Dave Smith in the McGregor Shell, Atlantic Siding number 71. Lowell A-Flag out there in the hard charge at number 9, the Challenger running out of Island Speed Equipment Quality Transmission and Lewis Smith Racing. Alan Vincent in the 28 out of Ford and Irving Summerside Chrysler Dodge Quality Transmission and the Joan Kennedy Tour for 1987. We got some great looking modifieds and they're going to pick up a green flag and get things underway right now. Here we go, Raceway Park Modified. Puts her into buckwheat real early. And Mad Max into a lead. Raymond Byrne in the 47 Birch Transmission Mopar.
Ward in a fresh motor hanging on in the 47, and Carl Livingston motoring in the 16. Roddy McDonald in a Poly Construction 44, sitting there in third spot at Lowell A. Flack. And Al McPhail are giving him the evil eye, I'll tell you. Yeah, pick it up in the information booth. Go on over there and grab one, folks. And your ballot for voting for your favorite driver and all the rest of it's in there as well. As the action continues hot and heavy on a Labor Day here at Raceway Park, Prince Edward Island's Motor Sports Complex. Okay, they got the green flag and they're underway once again. Raymond Burton down the backstretch. Oh, Downey Lowther puts her into the bucket over between one and two. And that'll leave him stationary for a minute, and it looks like we'll get another yellow here. Unless he gets out of the way in a hurry. Oh, Mad Max goes off with some problems, and Lowell Aflac jumps into the lead. We'll get a yellow here, too, by the looks of it, I think. Here it comes. Yellow flag is out. We'll get Donnie Lowther cleared out of the road there, and Mad Max lost his steering or something, and he just jumped in there. Our old pal Dave Smith there in the McGregor Shell Arms Atlantic Siding entry. Here we come. We got a green flag once again. Lowell A flag up front in the Challenger. 360 cubic inches of Mopar V8 power of Lewis Smith under the hood. Now McPhail makes his bid to move up into second spot here as he's gaining ground on the 16 of Carl Livingston. Some handling difficulties there. One more lap to go. That's the white flag, folks. You can see it on the flag stand. One more lap. And Lowell A flag. Carl Livingston can do the damage he needs to do in a hurry. We'll pick up the checkered flag for the heat. And here he comes for the win. Followed by Carl Livingston, the 29 of Al McPhail, 27 of Al Beaton. 27 of Alan Beaton actually is running the spare engine out of the 29 car. McPhail and Peters lending Alan Beaton their spare engine so he can keep going after he blew up here last weekend. That's the kind of camaraderie that develops in this sport amongst the competitors. Let's hear it for him. Lowell A. Flack at the number 9 out of Bedeck and that hard-charging Challenger. Nice hand for a Bucks as he heads out on a ride with the checkers. 360 cubic inch wedge power Dodge Challenger that utilizes a torque light, automatic transmission in second gear, I do believe. Car works well. Lewis Smith Racing, very instrumental in the horsepower that emanates from under the hood of that little Hummer. Lewis getting quite a name for building fine race engines, and of course he's right at Kincora right here in Prince Edward Island. Fine machinist and a sharp guy. Nice hand for folks at the number 9, Lowell A. Flag. Here we go, mini stock action once again. Wade Livingston in the half, Mike McCurbo in the 10, Mike Gallant in the 44, Paul McKenzie in the 4, Bob Ford 71, George 12 42, Bud Sutherland in the 74, Kevin McKay in the 6, Dave Reeves 55, Elmer Cameron 34, Kenny Goody in the 93, Mike Hicken in the 9, Wayne Phillips in the 82, Brett Van Dunkirken in the 2, and Shane Carmody in the 88. Action's hot and heavy in the mini stock division here today at Raceway Park. This final day of the Shell TLO Series for 1987 here at Prince Edward Island's Motor Sports Complex. Bob Ford running his strongest run all year, probably stronger in the 71. Mike Hicken and Dave Reeves are going to go by him simultaneously. Look at this already. Dave Reeves cuts in low and he almost... Oh! Oh, mercy. Oh, he's in big trouble there. Big trouble. Overdrove it, for sure, and he really stuffed that right front corner up in the 55. Out comes the yellow flag, and he really took a smack into that wall, no question about it. I thought it was going to be a lot worse than it was. Because when he came down to shoot and got folded up there, he headed straight for the wall. And there's a piece of automobile laying there in the track that they'll pick up. Make sure that's not hot, guys. I don't know where it came from. Watch it. And there's one bumper. We've got quite a collection of stuff here today, really, folks. Any of you folks over for the weekend from Halifax, Dartmouth area, watch for a Raceway Park special coming up on Halifax and Dartmouth, as well as the Bedford and Sackville Cable in the near future, courtesy of our friends at Dartmouth Cable, here on the crew today. We got a green flag underway. Mike McCarville in the Taylor's Garage, number 10. Mike Hicken in the East End Tire, number 9, getting by him on the inside as he takes over the lead, coming out of 3 and 4. Ford, George Boyle in the Video Pros entry. Kevin McKay in the number 6. McCarville and take over second spot, but it doesn't look like, oh, yes, he does. Look at him. Bob Ford moving up in second spot, coming in between 3 and 4 right now. It's neck and neck down the front stretch. Mike McCarville holding him off. There's a real race going on here for second spot as well as third right now. And Mike Hicken just runs away with it. Bob Ford gets a little out of shape as the back out of it. Mike McCarville back in sole possession of second. Kevin McKay in a Car Life Museum Team Toyota entry out of Taylor's Garage as well, running right up his tail, trying to make use of the track and get by him on a slingshot move. Fred Van Dunkirken doing a little drafting down the front stretch here on the tail end of Kevin McKay, and Bob Ford in fifth spot right now, followed by Elmer Cameron in the 34, Midas Muffler, Green Shore Tire Sales entry. front of the number nine. He's getting ready to start to lap the field. And there's the real race going on right now for second, third, and fourth. Mike McCarville desperately holding off Kevin McKay and Fred Van Dunkirken, who Fred goes high and tries to get by Kevin McKay on the outside and doesn't have quite enough sun. Last lap flag has been displayed. Mike Hicken will go through for the win, and he'll do that in just a moment. But the real race is on right now for these three guys here, all hoping to get second spot. Here goes Kevin McKay on the inside. Watch him down the back stretch as he tries to get a fender on Mike McCarville. Cannot do it. Mike McCarville shuts the door on him. Kevin McKay sets up early. Here they come down the chute. Oh, it's going to be another one to the wire. Second, third, and fourth there are awful close. We'll have to wait for the official on that. Mike Hicken, your winner in the East End Tire number 9 car. Originally campaigned by Lowell Aflack out of Bedeck. And Mike will come around here and pick up the checkers in just a moment. He's got that car working real, real well the last little while, for sure. We'll have a nice hand for him, folks, when he comes around to pick up the checkered flag. Hard charging Mike Hicken in the East End Tire number 9. Mike Hicken there, gang, as he comes back with a checkered flag here at Raceway Park. On the third day of a triple header, nice hand for him, gang. Let's hear it for him. Come on, you can do better than that. Louder. Hey. All right. Hey. That's better. Thank you. I love a high level of excitement. Makes my day. Sterling Rattray up front in the 31 this time around for their second heat for the Duke's division. First division, Daryl Matheson in the 92, Sandy McKay in the 43, Gerald McQuarrie in the 50, Fred Barrett in the 74, Greg McKenna in the 7, Walt McQuarrie in the 60, Daryl Ford 35, Joey McDonald in the 83, Dave Tierney in the 49. And Joey McDonald's trying to catch up to Gerald McQuarrie there. Gerald in the 50, Joey in the 83, Greg McKenna in the 7. He gets a little mixed up over there. Joey McDonald makes the straight. Now Greg McKenna tries to get underneath. As they're almost three abreast going into the turns, these guys are really loaded up today and ready to rifle it. As the final day in the Shell TLO Point Series for 1987 here in Raceway Park. Sterling Rattray way out front, and Gerald McQuarrie, oh, so bad, over between one and two. He's going to be okay. He'll come back out on Daryl Ford in the Oyster Bed Esso entry, down on the inside as well. Problem here. Whoa! Out with the yellow, gang, and we'll pick up Dave's trunk lid. Sterling Rattray goes around it all right. Scott Livingston managed to get by it. And these guys are really motoring. Super Dave says, gosh, look at all that stuff on the ground, not knowing, of course, that that it's his trunk lid that's laying there. We'll get that picked up in a minute. Dave, Super Dave, by the way, to my knowledge, a little bit of trivia here for you, is the only guy ever to race one of those little fastback cutlasses on this racetrack. I don't think anybody else has ever used one of those bodies. We've had a lot of bodies used up around this place and a lot of bodies that don't look too good, including mine. But that's the first slope back that I've ever seen on this track, and he's had about three seasons out of that as Shuffling Jeff Rodenizer throws the deck lid over into the ever mounting pile of parts that we've got on this side of the guardrail. We got enough stuff to open up a record yard here when we get through to that, I think. Face bars, package trays, lower valances, and all kinds of good things. We'll have a green flag this time around here so we can keep things going. You get a good shot of that trunk lid there over all the folks at home. There we go. We'll get a green one. There you can see it. Blake Craswell gets it to him, and we're all set.
Hey, Melvin.
Pulls into the pit, or into the infield, with a problem with his right front wheel. Take a look over there in the infield, and you'll see the number 17 sitting right next to the Jeep there. He has problems with his front wheel. Livingston clips him. Wade McKinnon on the other side of Dave Tierney in the 81. There he goes. He's going for it, folks. Going for the gusto. He'd like to build up some points here. Well, Marv Dyer's 17 is sitting in the infield, and here he comes on the outside. Joey McDonald in the Service Master entry. Oh, and a mix-up over there in the turn as Dave Tierney gets messed up. And there's your winner, Joey McDonald, followed by Wade McKinnon and Scott Livingston in third, unofficially. Sterling Rattray with a lot of smoke coming off the left front wheels. He's got some sheet metal effects there when he gets back to the pits. Okay, nice hand for a folks. There he is, Joey McDonald in the Service Master number 83. Have a nice hand for a folks, the 83 of Joey McDonald as he picks up checkered flags. Had quite a year.
Thank you.
down everything as it happens, and we'll have in the proper order up there. So the Raceway Park Rain Trucks, better known as the Black Sisters, they'll take care of that for us upstairs, I'm sure.
Of steel out there in that track all at once, and they all want to be in the same place, namely in the lead. Oh, this will definitely be interesting. We'll probably weave some laundry before this one's over, I'll tell you. Oh, my. Darrell Matheson up front, and Dan Singleton next to him, and Scott Livingston in the 24. Henry Lenzel back in the 57. Yeah, that's about $250,000, Earl's just telling me, were the cars when they were new, which they aren't now, of course. Scott Osmond in the 03, Walt McQuarrie, then Dave Tierney, Flip McLeod, Gal Jollymore, and Marv Dyer on the other side, Kevin Shaw, Jerry McKinnon. Look at them all. Here we go. We're underway. 35 laps of incredible action. And the largest Dukes of Hazzard race ever staged in Eastern Canada. And there goes Scott Livingston as he roars into an early lead. Oh, Singleton's already mixed up with the 92 of Darrell. And Marv Dyer making it on the grass on the inside into 17 as he crashes back down onto the track surface. Oh, look at all this. Oh, for heaven's sake, what a mess. They're all over the place. Oh, my heart. A bit of a mix-up going into that first turn. Isn't this interesting? Oh, my heavens. And the Brackley Jeep Eagle cleanup crew hanging on the tailgate and heading over to the corner there to get everything straightened out. It's it looks a lot worse than it really is. And I got a shot of the guys on the flag stand here on my monitor at the moment, courtesy of the guys at Dartmouth Cable. And our thanks to a fine group of fellows here, Peter, Paul, and Sean, who has been with us all weekend, videoing all the activities here, both on the stock car track and on the drag strip. They've been busy fellas. They've been set up all weekend long and doing a great number for us. We've seen some of the rushes in the last couple of days, and they've got some really, really fine footage. On the other side of the 49. Marv Dyer to 17, Walt McQuarrie, Flip McLeod, Darrell Matheson, Jerry McKinnon, Kevin Shaw. Al Suxbury. And here we go once again. Henry Lenzel's going in high, high, high. Scott Livingston stays oh so low and pulls into the lead in the 24 car. Fifty laps is a long, long way to go, my friendlies. Look at him fly. Here comes your leader, Scott Livingston in the 24. Henry Lenzel, Marv Dyer in the 17. Scott Osmond in the 03. Dave Tierney moving under Kevin Shaw and sitting up in sixth spot. Lauren Bingley with a wheel off. Lauren Bingley with no wheel on the right rear corner. And the wheel will take a turn and go right into the pit by the looks of things. There it goes, on down into the pit area. So we don't need a yellow on that one anyway. Here comes Super Dave. Oh man, what a mess. Look at him go. There's your leader, Scott Livingston. Henry Lenzel being passed by Marv Dyer on the inside. Working their way through the traffic. This ought to be fun. Scott Livingston laps the first car. As he gets around on the inside, he's trying to stay out of trouble in the traffic. He'll go, out comes the yellow flag, and we got one stopped here on our Sterling Rattray's in bad shape. All on the wall here. Darrell Matheson goes pit side in the 92. Sterling Rattray in the 31. Roger Miller, a little out of shape in the 80, but he pulls her back in. everybody sorted out and get them in order here. Picks up a black flag for filing into car number 80. On the inside as he takes the lead on the front stretch. Center of the infield there too. I don't know. Oh, he's got a flat right rear tire. By the looks of it, he'll hit pit side. No, it looks like the axle may be pushed out of position. I'm not just sure. It's kind of tough to see from here, but he's going to hit pit side with it anyway.
Doesn't matter what.
Let your stands come up, man.
Okay, I do believe they're all lined up here in order and ready to go. Done them up, obviously, because of the number of cars that's out there. If you run them single file, the lead car is almost into the back end of the tail car as soon as you get the flag dropped. So if you double them up, that shortens up the length of the line somewhat so they can string out a little bit and get with the program. Here we go. Green flag once again. Marvin Dyer and the FR McLean Dodge rolls into the lead. Dave Tierney right on his tail. And Scott Osmond in the 03, Henry Lenzel in the 57. Marv Dyer in the 17. Scott Osmond in second spot. Dave Tierney third. And the 57 of Henry Lenzel fourth at the moment. Up front in the 17, and Scott Osmond in second spot right now, and I believe Dave Tierney running third. Rather.
drops a wheel and puts them off. Apparently is leaking fuel. That's what happened to him. In second spot. I believe Lester McLeod in the 01 car is actually running third right now. Is in third position actually right now. Marv Dyer in the lead. Speedy Auto Glass, or Speedy Muffler rather, Queens County Construction Dodge. In the 17, Speedy Muffler, Queens County Construction entry, your winner of your 50 lapper.
Okay, we need Duke's number 78, Kevin McDade's number 6, and Eddie McClaren, okay? Super Dave, Kevin McDade, Eddie McClaren out.
Eye of the Community, Dartmouth Cable TV.